Hi guys, welcome to Dr. Anil Works, easy way to study. This is Dr. Anil. So guys, आज हम देखने वाले हैं माइक्रोबायोलॉजी का सेकेंड टॉपिक, सेकेंड पॉइंट, दैट मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन. और भी कुछ टॉपिक्स पॉइंट्स हम देखेंगे, बट जो भी नए नए से जुड़े हैं हमारे से, उनके लिए बताना चाहता हूँ कि हम वेरी बेसिकली मीन्स फर्स्ट वीडियो के इनिशियली हम एक क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं, जो मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन होते हैं उसके, तो उसका आंसर हम ड्यूरिंग कोर्स तक सोचते हैं, और उसके बाद लास्ट में एट द एंड आई गिव यू द आंसर एंड द एक्सप्लेनेशन आल्सो. सो द माय मोटिव बिहाइंड दैट इज़ कि हर एक वीडियो से आपको कम से कम 15 से 25 MCQ का नॉलेज मिल सके, और वो जो मेन वीडियो होता है, मतलब जो टेक्स्ट बुक से हमारा जो भी इंफॉर्मेशन मिलती है वो तो इम्पोर्टेंट होती है, उससे नंबर ऑफ MCQ तो बन ही जाते. सो दिस इज़ द रीज़न आई एम डूइंग ऑल दिस थिंग. सो व्हाट आई एम थिंकिंग इज़ दैट हमारा MCQ और थियोरेटिकल पार्ट बोथ एक साइड बाय साइड बोथ साथ में चले, ठीक है गाइस. सो टुडेज MCQ इज़ क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. हम पाँच MCQ हमने कर चुका है, सो जस्ट मेक श्योर दैट पाँच मतलब हमने 125 MCQ का नॉलेज गेन कर चुके हैं. यह आज का छठवां MCQ है. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट गाइस, लेट्स गो फर्दर. ओके, सो टुडेज MCQ नंबर 6 MCQ इज ट्रू स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग मस्कुलोक्यूटेनस नर्व. व्हाट इज द ट्रू स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग मस्कुलोक्यूटेनस नर्व? ओके गाइस, सो ऑप्शन इज ए, इट रिसीव्स फाइबर्स फ्रॉम 8 सर्वाइकल स्पाइनल रूट. बी, कंटेन्स ओनली सेंसरी फाइबर्स. सी, ब्रांच ऑफ लेटरल कॉर्ड ऑफ ब्रैकियल प्लेक्सस. डी, लीव्स द प्लेक्सस एट पॉइंट एट विच इट क्रॉस द फर्स्ट रिब. सो दीज आर द ऑप्शंस, सो यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट द राइट वन. सो एट द एंड ऑफ वीडियो you will get the answer also and with explanation. So be honest and find out the answer, or you try to give answer for. Okay, so now today let's start with our microbiology. Microbiology, what we are doing is mode of transmission. Okay guys, so in mode of transmission we will be studying, because earlier, okay, one more thing, that we are referring to the book Apurva. Okay, so please guys, do refer from that also. This is section 1 of general microbiology. Okay. So mode of transmission. In mode of transmission, microorganism may be transmitted from the reservoir or source to susceptible host in different ways. So as those who have seen my earlier videos knows that what is reservoir and what is source. Okay guys, so please do look at earlier videos, you will be able to know. That's why it is important to be in line, right? So in continuity, because we cannot go back and explain any everything. So okay guys, so just see, we have explained in detail what is wire and source, everything. So now again I'm telling you, microorganism may be transmitted from reservoir or source to susceptible host in different ways. Okay, so what are all the ways, wo humko janna hai. First ways is contact. Okay, so what is mode of transmission? Main one, first mode of transmission is contact. Okay, so infection may be transmitted by direct or indirect contact. Okay, so nowadays it's corona time period, so just link that thing to here, as human to human contact is there, right? So direct contact is via skin, mucosa of infected person, for example through unclean hand or kissing or sexual contact. Okay guys, so organism transmitted by direct contact includes agents of common cold, okay, skin and eye infection, agents of sexually transmitted diseases such as HIV and Neisseria gonorrhoeae, chlamydia trichomonas, and Treponema pallidum. So all these are the agents which transmitted by direct contact. So you can be asking, you'll be asking the exam that what are all the, which of the following is transmitted by direct contact. So example mein diya hoga HIV, Neisseria gonorrhoeae, Chlamydia trichomonalis and Treponema pallidum. So answer should be all of the above, right? All are. So this is how they make MCQ. So now we'll see second, indirect. Okay, we have seen direct. Indirect, you know, indirect is through the agency of fomites which are inanimate objective. Okay, which are inanimate objective, such as which are inanimate objective such as clothing, toys, etc. And these may be contaminated by the pathogens and act as a vehicle for its transmission. For example, face towel shared by a various person may be lead to spread of trachoma. Okay guys, so this is the indirect. So how is indirect spread? By clothings, by toys, or sharing a face towel, etc. Now the second way is inhalation. Inhalation agents means agents causing respiratory infection are acquired by inhalation route. So these organisms are shed into environment by patients in secretion from nose or throat through during sneezing, coughing, speaking in the form of droplets. So droplet spread is what? When person sneezes forcefully, right? So you know that again link a coronavirus example to this, because one of the way of spreading corona is droplet infection, right? So this is droplet. You can link that, easily understand. There is nothing to explain. Now airborne transmission. So droplet nuclei is less than 10 micro size, can remain suspended in air for longer period and can act as a source of infection. Means the size which is less or less than 10 micrometer size, so that can suspend in air for longer period, okay, and act as a source of infection. So droplet or the dust transmission that larger than 10 micrometer travel a short distance, okay, and settle down on the clothing and other objects, become a part of dust. So they can infect only those persons who come in contact with the source. So organism transmitted through this route include respiratory virus, for example influenza, parainfluenza, adenovirus, respiratory syncytial virus and Bordelia pertussis. And now one more is added to this criteria is what? You all know, as you are locked right now, locked down for because of that, is coronavirus. Okay, so coronavirus is also a larger size. Okay, so the virus which are larger than 10 micrometer can travel a short distance, settle down on the clothings or any other objects and become a part of dust. So they can infect only those person who come in contact with source. Organism transmitted through this route includes respiratory. So all these are organisms. So this is also a related to coronavirus. Okay, so this is one example. Now airborne droplet or droplet nuclei transmission. When the droplet is small or 1 to 10 micrometer. Okay, so it can travel a long distance and can infect any person and it finds on its way. So primary contact with the source is not necessary. So organism transmitted through this route include agents causing tuberculosis, measles and chickenpox. So you can just think about the dangerous severity of which the severity is this one. Airborne transmission of less or smaller size pathogens, okay, or larger is less pathogenic. Means by way of transmission, this can infect less people, but this can infect larger people. So tuberculosis is more dangerous than corona, okay. But nowadays tuberculosis has treatment, that's why everybody is free or can relax, or even tuberculosis has vaccine, BCG vaccine, right? So again, ingestion. Third way of transmission is ingestion. So intestinal infection like cholera, dysentery, food poisoning, and most of the parasitic infection are acquired by ingestion of food or drink contaminated by the pathogens. So foodborne infection occur mostly through carriers engaged in handling or preparation of food and contaminating the foodstuffs. The water supply may get contaminated with the feces of the patients or carriers. All these may transmit the infection. So of course the food is the main, food or drinking is contaminated by pathogen, okay. So foodborne infection is comes, okay. This you can understand. Incubation. What is incubation? Pathogens in some instances may inoculated, sorry, inoculation. Okay, inoculation. So pathogens in some instances may be inoculated directly into skin or tissue of the host. It can penetrate skin and go and locate themselves on the skin. Okay, inoculate themselves inside. Okay, so may inoculate. So for example, animal bite. For example, right, rabies virus is inoculated directly by the bite of rabies animal. Okay, rabid animal, and inoculated directly into tissue. For example, spore of Clostridium tetani. Okay, present in soil and get deposited directly into the host tissue, following the severe wounds leading to tetanus. Okay, so tetanus and rabies are the example of inoculated ways of transmission. Okay, now transmission of bloodborne infection. We'll see transmission of bloodborne infection. So bloodborne infection such as hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and HIV may be transmitted by needle pick and other sharp injuries. I hope you all know this because lots of awareness has been spread because for this. Okay, so again, the blood transmission is one of the way. Intravenous drug abuse is one of the way. Contaminated needles is one of the, even the sexual intercourse, right? Now vector borne or mechanical or biological ways of transmission. So arthropod vector, anthropod vector such as mosquitoes, flies, fleas, ticks, mites, and lice are the vectors that transmits many disease. The vector may be of two types. Okay, one is a mechanical vector and biological vector. So what is mechanical and biological vector? We have seen in last in last video. So biological vector is the one that pathogen completes some developmental cycle in it, and mechanical vector is only a carrier. Okay, so they carry the microorganism which do not multiply and transmit them to the eatables. Okay, जो भी उसको खाएगा या उसके पास आएगा. बायोलॉजिकल वेक्टर क्या है? तो पैथोजन मल्टीप्लाई इन द बॉडी ऑफ वेक्टर एंड ऑफन अंडरगोइंग अ पार्ट ऑफ डेवलपमेंट साइकिल इन इट. सच वेक्टर्स आर नेम बायोलॉजिकल वेक्टर्स. फॉर एग्जांपल, फिनल एनोफिलस मस्किटो इन मलेरिया एंड क्यूलेक्स मस्किटो इन फिलेरियासिस. ओके, सो हियर इज, हियर बिकम्स अ वन एमसीक्यू दैट फिलेरियासिस इज ट्रांसमिटेड बाय विच वेक्टर. आंसर इज क्यूलेस मस्किटो. ऑप्शन इज क्यूलेक्स, एनाफिलस और एडिस एजिप्टी एंड ऑल ऑफ द अबव. सो द आंसर विल बी क्यूलेक्स मस्किटो. ओके गाइस, सो दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर यू. फिलेरियासिस, क्यूलेस मॉस्किटो कैन कॉज फिलेरिया, मीन्स इज वेक्टर फॉर ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ फिलेरिया. एक्सट्रिंसिक इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड, दिस ऑल्सो वी हैव स्टडीड लास्ट लास्ट वीडियो. आफ्टर द एंट्री ऑफ अ पैथोजन इन टू द वेक्टर एंड द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द वेक्टर टू बिकम इन्फेक्टिव इज कॉल्ड एज एक्सट्रिंसिक इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड. नाउ वी विल सी, वी हैव इन डिटेल डिस्कस ऑन दिस. ओके गाइज, सो यू कैन सी अर्लियर वीडियोज, यू विल गेट टू नो दैट. वर्टिकल ट्रांसमिशन, what is vertical transmission? It refers to the transmission of infection from mother to fetus. Okay, this is vertical transmission. Vertical transmission is mother to fetus. So it may be characterized into that transplacental transmission. So infection occurs via placental barrier, leads to abortion, miscarriage and stillbirth. Understood? So any infection which can, means the infection which can occur via placental barrier, that can lead to abortion, that can lead to miscarriage, or that can lead to stillbirth. If the babies are born, they suffer from the congenital malformation. Means even if the if this is not happened, then if baby is still born, then congenital malformation will be there. Such infections are known as the teratogenic infection. Okay, what they are known as teratogenic infection. So examples include torch infection. Okay, what is torch? It's a question for you. Okay, what is torch? Torch infection, toxoplasma, others that treponema pallidum, varicella zoster and rubella virus, these are one of from this, right? Rubella, toxoplasma, other. Okay guys, so now we'll see, we'll go further, the transmitted, and the other one is the cytomegalus and herpes simplex virus. So here is the option answer of the torch. Torch is what? It includes the toxoplasma, others like treponema pallidum and varicella zoster virus, then rubella, R for rubella, C for cytomegalus and H for herpes simplex virus. So these are the one of the favorite MCQ. Okay, torch MCQ. Torch, what is torch infection? So now you know that torch, T is for toxoplasma, O is for other includes treponema pallidum, varicella zoster virus, and R is for rubella virus, C is for cytomegalus and H is for herpes zoster. Okay guys, now transmission via birth canal. Okay, so transmission via birth canal is without causing congenital malformation in the baby. Example include group B streptococcus, N gonorrhea, and C trachomatis and listeria and viruses, etc. For example, hepatitis B and HIV. So now we will see this table. Okay, so why, one more thing I want to tell you, that why we shifted to the Apurva book, because the Apurva book is quite point, they have mentioned very good in points, and even they include the tables like this. Okay, which lacks in the Anant Narayan. Anant Narayan is very good book and is a favorite of many teachers, but for students I think this can catch, this can attract students. Okay, because this is very important for us. Okay, so now we'll see the human infection transmitted and what are the vectors or what they can transmit. Okay, so these, only these tables can be very helpful, and can many MCQ can be make from this, as microbiology is a dry subject because it includes lots of facts. So we need to study it again and again, or you can see this video again and again, then you'll be able to retain this information for longer time. Okay guys, So let's see, mosquito. So mosquito can cause a human infection of malaria, filariasis, yellow fever, Japanese encephalitis, and dengue fever. So this mosquito can get different, right? Means like anopheles can cause malaria, culex can cause filariasis, so on. Dengue, Aedes aegypti can cause dengue fever, etc. Okay, so that will be the different part, but in general, we see that mosquito is the vector for malaria, filariasis, yellow fever, Japanese encephalitis, and dengue fever. This Japanese encephalitis is one of the rising topic just recent time in India only. Okay, then again, sandfly can cause Kala Azar, means is a vector for Kala Azar, Oriental sore, sandfly fever, Oroya fever. Again, I'm telling you, sandfly is a vector for which causes humans a Kala Azar, Oriental sore, sandfly fever, or Oroya fever. Hard tick is a vector for a disease like tick typhus, Kaisanur forest disease. Kaisanur forest disease is also denoted by KFD, and babesiosis and tularemia. Okay, tularemia. Again, I'm repeating this. Hard tick is a vector for the disease like tick typhus, Kayanasur forest disease like KFD, babesiosis, and tularemia. And if there is a hard tick, then there has to be soft tick. So soft tick is Q fever, endemic relapsing fever, and again other one is the rat flea. This rat flea is a vector for bubonic plague, endemic typhus, or Hymenolepis diminuta. Again, I'm telling you, a rat flea is a vector for bubonic plague, endemic typhus, Hymenolepis diminuta. Next, trombiculid mite is a vector for scrub typhus and rickettsial pox. And tsetse fly is, why tsetse fly? The T is a silent. Okay, tsetse fly is a vector for sleeping sickness. So sleeping sickness is a disease. The only vector of this disease is tsetse fly. Okay, again, then house fly is a vector for typhoid fever, paratyphoid fever, cholera, and gastroenteritis and trachoma. Okay, and louse is one which is a vector for epidemic typhus. Okay, epidemic typhus and epidemic relapsing fever. Okay guys, and trench fever. So if you have अगर केयरफुली आपने देखा होगा तो दिस इज एपिडेमिक रिलैप्सिंग फीवर. ओके गाइस, एंड हियर यू हैव सीन एंडेमिक टाइफस. ओके, एंड हियर यू हैव सीन एपिडेमिक टाइफस. ओके, एंड वन मोर रिलैप्सिंग फीवर वी जस्ट स्पोक दैट एंडेमिक रिलैप्सिंग फीवर. ओके गाइस, सो there are two terms, epidemic typhus and endemic typhus. But endemic typhus is caused by rat flea, and epidemic typhus is caused by louse. Okay, and endemic relapsing fever is caused by soft tick. Okay, but epidemic relapsing fever is caused by louse. So louse can cause epidemic typhus also and epidemic relapsing fever also. Okay, and but the endemic typhus and endemic relapsing fever is a have a different vector. That soft tick is a vector for endemic relapsing fever, and endemic typhus vector of this is rat flea. Okay, then Chagas disease. The vector of Chagas disease is Radu wilt bug, and the Guinea worm disease, and the fish tapeworm, and guinea worm disease, and vector for this is Cyclops. Cyclops is a vector for this. Okay guys, so now we'll see the mechanism of microbial pathogenicity. Okay, how that pathogenicity occurs. Okay, so ability of microbe to produce diseases or tissue injury is often referred to as a too loosely or too closely related, but not loosely, it is a closely related but not a synonyms term, pathogenicity and virulence. Okay, the pathogenicity virulence has a different meaning, so we will first discuss this term, then we'll go in detail. Again, ability of microbe to produce a disease or tissue injury is often referred to as a too closely related but not a synonyms, so these are not a synonyms word but a close related, that pathogenicity and virulence. Okay, so there is a lot of confusion between these two. Okay, so pathogenicity is generally employed to refer to the ability of microbial species to produce disease. Understood? What is pathogenicity? Pathogenicity is a ability of microorganism, ability of microbial species to produce disease is called pathogenicity. Okay, again, what is, while the term virulence is most or more specifically to describe the relative degree of pathogenesis. Okay, so degree of pathogenesis is described by term virulence. So pathogenesis is the tissue damage, which, okay, pathogenesis is the mechanism and pathogenicity is a ability or capability of microbial species to produce disease. Understood, guys? Okay, so which may vary between different strains of same organism depending upon the expression of virulence factor. Understood? This can vary or this can be a different between different strain of same organism, means two or four, I like this much organism virulence is different and this much organism virulence is different. Okay, this has more virulence, this has less virulence. Understood? So this is what, so the virulence is a relative term, it changes depending upon the expression of virulence factor which cause the tissue damage. Okay, so different strains of same species may exhibit varying degree of virulence. Okay, some strains are highly virulent while some strains are low and some are avirulent, means cannot cause a disease or cannot damage a tissue. Okay, and so they are used as a vaccine strain. Okay, now going further, the virulence of the strain may undergo spontaneous or induced variation. Now I think you have understood totally that what is pathogenicity and what is virulence. Okay guys, so please make sure both these term. Okay, now here we are, the virulence of the strain may undergo spontaneous or induced variations. Exaltation is enhancement of virulence, is known as exaltation. What is exaltation? Exaltation means enhancement of virulence. Virulence we can increase, if the virulence is increased we call it as exaltation, which can be induced experimentally by serial passage into susceptible host. If there are susceptible host, who is susceptible host, by the way? Susceptible host is one that which who can get infected or get a damage, that tissue is get damaged by these microbes. Okay, this is susceptible, or which has, means jinki immunity low ho jayegi ya fir jo uske prone hoga, prone to infection us tarike se. Okay, so hum induce kar sakte experimentally virulence ko. Okay, means virulence enhance कर सकते हैं experimentally हम लोग, इतना याद रखना है। अगेन attenuation, what is attenuation? Now you have understood the exaltation, okay? And now attenuation. Attenuation is the reduction of virulence. So attenuation is opposite of, okay, exaltation. So which can be achieved by passage of through unfavorable host, repeated culture in the artificial media, growth in the high temperature, or in the presence of weak antiseptics, or desiccation, or prolonged storage in the culture. Understood? It refers to that reduction of virulence which can be achieved by passage through unfavorable host. Unfavorable host na hoga ek repeated culture in the artificial media lenge, और ग्रोथ इन द हाई टेम्परेचर, हाई टेम्परेचर में ग्रोथ होगा अगर देखेंगे, इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ वीक एंटीसेप्टिक्स, एंटीसेप्टिक्स अगर देगा तब भी उसका एटीन्यूएशन हो जाएगा, और डेसिकेशन और प्रोलॉन्ग स्टोरेज इन द कल्चर। ओके, दीज आर द एटीन्यूएशन। सो पैथोजेनिसिटी ऑफ अ वायरल, फंगल एंड पैरासाइटिक डिजीज आर एक्सप्लेन इन द रिस्पेक्टिव। ओके, सो बैक्टेरियल पैथोजेनिसिस इज डिस्क्राइब। बैक्टेरियल पैथोजेनिसिटी डिपेंड्स अपॉन सम total of several factors. Okay, so now we will see the routes of transmission of infection. I think we have studied this. Okay, routes of transmission, again we'll just rapid firely see this. Route of transmission of infection plays a crucial role in the pathogenicity of certain bacteria. Some bacteria such as the streptococci can initiate the infection whatever be the mode of entry. Others can survive and multiply only when introduced by the optimal routes. Cholera, vibrio are infective orally but are unable to cause infection when introduced subcutaneously. So you can see here that the cholera, vibrio cholerae are only infective, means can cause a disease when they infect a host by oral route. Okay, but they cannot cause infection or they cannot cause disease by when they get infected, they get inside like inoculated through by subcutaneously. Okay, so this difference is probably related to the modes by which the different bacteria are able to initiate tissue damage or establish themselves. Means the mode is also a very important factor to cause a disease. Okay, now we'll see infective dose of organism. What is infective dose? Okay, so infective dose of organism is referred to as a minimum inoculum size, inoculum size that is capable of initiating an infection. So this is infective dose. So infective dose plays a major role in determining whether the disease is going to set in or not. Okay, so low infective dose means certain organism requires a relatively small inoculum or to initiate infection. Means who has a low infective dose, that means that organism requires a less dose to cause infection. Okay, so Shigella it is very low. So this can be the MCQ. And how low? As low as 10 bacilli. Only 10 bacilli of Shigella can cause infection. Okay, but the Cryptosporidium parvum is also very low. They can 10 to 30 oocytes of Cryptosporidium parvum can cause infection. E. coli, that is Escherichia coli, O157:H7. These organism can be also very very low, that less than 10 bacilli. Okay, less than 10 bacilli can also cause disease. Entamoeba coli or Giardia, a few cysts is enough to cause infection. So this also has a low infective dose. And Campylobacter jejuni, this needs around 500 bacilli to cause infection. Okay, so these are the less infective dose, these organisms which are with less infective dose. Okay, so these the only few oocytes or few bacilli needs. Okay, again now we will see the larger one, example of larger one. So make sure guys all the line is making one MCQ. Okay, so be careful to read it again. Large infective dose. What is large infective dose? In contrast, the organism with high infective dose can initiate the infection only when the inoculum size exceeds a particular critical size. Okay, like E. coli, but here what we see, E. coli O157 is to H7. Okay, this needs less than 10 bacilli, but only Escherichia coli needs 10 raised to 6 or 10 raised to 8 bacilli. But and Salmonella needs 10 raised to 2 to 10 raised to 5 bacilli. Means this is very large number. Okay, Vibrio cholerae also needs large number, 10 raised to 6 to 10 raised to 8. So Escherichia coli and Vibrio cholerae has a same number, that is large infective dose. Okay, so E. coli, Vibrio cholerae and Salmonella, these are the same examples, so do remember guys. Okay, now infective dose varies depending upon the factors such as virulence of organism. Higher the virulence, lower is the infective dose. Okay, विरुलेंस के ऊपर डिपेंड होता है इन्फेक्टिव डोज. जैसे इन विरुलेंस अगर हायर होगा, ऑफकोर्स द डोज विल बी गेट लोज. होस्ट एज एंड ओवरऑल इम्यून स्टेटस, मीन्स इम्यून स्टेटस लो होगा तो ऑफकोर्स लो डोज लगेगा. अगर इम्यून स्टेटस इम्यून ज़्यादा होगी, अच्छी होगी इम्यून, तो ज़्यादा डोज लगेगा. और होस्ट का एज अगर एडल्ट होगा, ज़्यादा बीमार होगा, ज़्यादा ओल्ड एज होगा, तो कम लगेगा उसको इन्फेक्ट होने में, या चाइल्ड होगा फिर भी. Okay, so ability of an organism resist the gastric acidity, that this also can increase or decrease the dose. So Shigella has an ability to survive in the gastric acidity. Oh, this is one of the quite surviving for Shigella. Shigella survives the gastric acidity. Do you know what is the pH of stomach? It is as less as 2, means 2 is the pH, means this is that much acidic, and this Shigella can even survive in this. So it's quite strange, has an ability to survive. Even a low infective dose can initiate the infection, and still it has a low infective dose. And in contrast, Vibrio is extremely acid level, means Vibrio cholerae cannot survive in gastric. So hence they requires a heavy inoculum to bypass the gastric barrier. Okay, now we'll see the adhesion. What is adhesion? So adhesions of the bacteria to the body surface is the initial event in the pathogenesis of disease. So it is mediated by specialized molecules called adhesin, which bind. I hope you got this. Adhesin, which binds the specific host cell to receptor. Okay, host cell receptors. Again, adhesion of a bacteria to body surface is the initial event in the pathogenesis of disease. Okay. So, वो कैसे होता है, उसके लिए एक स्पेशलाइज मॉलिक्यूल लगेगा अपने को, एडेजिन नाम का. सो एडेजिन क्या करेगा, वो बाइंड करेगा बैक्टीरिया को टू स्पेसिफिक होस्ट सेल को, होस्ट सेल के रिसेप्टर से. ओके, कौन बाइंड करेगा, एडेजिन मॉलिक्यूल. सो द एडेरेंस प्रिवेंट्स द बैक्टीरिया फ्रॉम बींग फ्लश अवे इन द सिक्रीशन एंड ऑल्सो द फैसिलिटेट द बैक्टीरियल इन्वेजन इन टू होस्ट सेल. अंडरस्टूड? सो ये प्रिवेंट करता है कि फ्लश आउट होने से. ओके, एडेजन्स. सो दिस इज हेल्पिंग अ बैक्टीरिया टू स्टे और इंटैक्ट एट दैट प्लेस ओनली. नाउ व्हाट आर ऑल द एडेजन्स? सो वन इज द फिम्ब्रे और पिलाय. ओके, अदर वन इज अ नॉन पाइलस एडेजिन, एंड थर्ड वन इज अ बायोफिल्म फॉर्मेशंस. नाउ वील सी वन बाय वन. Fimbriae or pili, they are the most important adhesins presents in the some bacteria, they directly bind to the sugar residue or glycolipid or glycoprotein on the host cells. What, where they bind? They bind to the sugar residue, okay, or glycolipid or glycoprotein on the host cell. Again, non-pilocytogens. What is non-pilocytogens? Non-pilocytogen is apart from pili, they are other adhesins found in certain bacteria, such as M protein or Streptococcus pyogenes, or lipoticoic acid. Lipoticoic acid is gram positive cocci, or cell surface lecithin is chlamydia. So these are the examples. Okay, now biofilm formation. Biofilm formation, it is the another mechanism by which a certain bacteria mediate strong adherence to certain structure, such as catheter, prosthetic implants, and heart walls. So biofilm is a group of bacterial cells which stick to each other on surface and are embedded within the layer called as a slim layer of a self-produced matrix of extracellular polymeric substance called glycocalyx. Okay guys, these are the three, that fimbriae or pili. Fimbriae is, you have understood very well, right? Means they directly bind to sugar residue like glycolipids and glycoproteins. And non-pilus is one, they use other types of adhesins, such as M protein is used by Streptococcus pyogenes. Okay, lipoic acid is used by gram positive cocci, and self surface lecithin used by chlamydia. Okay, and what is biofilm? Biofilm is the one, means they make group, they come in a group and attach or stick to each other, okay, and they adhere to the surface, okay, and form a layer, and that layer is called as a slim layer, okay, which is produced by, and they produce a self-produced matrix, okay, that slim layer, the matrix, extracellular polymeric substance, that substance is called as a glycocalyx. So this glycocalyx is secreted by this organism only, okay. And one more thing is how they come in contact with humans, like by catheters, okay, there is a prosthetic implants, and other one is heart walls. Now we will see invasions. Okay guys, so what is invasion? Invasion refers to the entry of bacteria into the host cells. Okay, bacteria goes into host cells. How? By what entry? So this is invasion. Okay, leading to the spread within the host tissue. Okay guys, so invasion is, some are highly invasive, like highly invasive pathogens produce spreading or generalized lesion. Pathogens, general lesion, for example streptococcal infections is invasion, while less invasive pathogens are causes localized lesion. Means highly invasive pathogen jo hote wo spreads ho jate hai aur wo banate wo generalized, matlab pure body mein infection cause karenge, aur less invasive jo honge wo kya karenge, localized lesion produce karenge, unko bolenge streptococcal abscess. Means for example kya hai uska, streptococcal abscess. Streptococcal abscess localized lesion form karenge, और जनरलाइज लीजन कौन फॉर्म करेगा, स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस इन्फेक्शन. ओके, स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल. नाउ सम पैथोजेंस दो कैपेबल ऑफ कॉजिंग अ फेटल डिजीज एंड लैक इन्वेजिवनेस, बट रिमेन कन्फाइंड टू द साइट ऑफ एंट्री एंड प्रोड्यूस डिजीज बाय एलोबरेटिंग टू पोटेंट टॉक्सिन्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम टिटैनस. इन साइट ऑफ एंट्री इंपॉर्टेंट है, और लेकिन एक डैमेज, बहुत डेंजरस डिजीज कॉज कर सकता है, वो ऑर्गेनिज्म कौन सा है, क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम टिटैनी. ओके, नाउ विल सी द इम्पॉर्टेंट विरुलेंस फैक्टर्स. ओके, सो दैट हेल्प इन इन्वेजन इंक्लूड. ओके, दैट हेल्प इन इन्वेजन्स, कौन सा ऐसा विरुलेंस फैक्टर है जो इन्वेजन के लिए हेल्प करेगा। ओके एक शिगेला, शिगेला के लिए है विरुलेंस मार्कर एंटीजेंस और इन्वेजन प्लाज्मिड एंटीजेंस। ओके दीज आर द विरुलेंस फैक्टर विच हेल्प्स टू इन टू इन्वेजन इन्वेजन ओके इन्वेजन ऑफ दैट बैक्टीरिया एंड देर आर सम एंजाइम्स ऑल्सो। सो इन्वेजन ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इज एनहांस्ड बाय मेनी एंजाइम्स सच एज हाइलुरोनिडेज, कोलेजिनेज, स्ट्रेप्टोकाइनेज एंड IgA प्रोटीज। दीज आर द एंजाइम विच हेल्प्स द बैक्टीरिया टू इन्वेड और इन्वेजिव इन गोज और एंट्री विच हेल्प्स एंट्री ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इन टू द होस्ट। ओके नाउ वी विल सी दिस टेबल और डायग्राम और एंटी फैगोसाइटिक फैक्टर्स। वॉट इज एंटी फैगोसाइटिक फैक्टर? द बैक्टीरियाज आर रैपिडली किल्ड वंस दे आर इंजेस्टेड बाय फैगोसाइट्स। ओके मीन्स वॉट हैपन, फर्स्ट बैक्टीरिया, दिस इज बैक्टीरिया, दे कम इन टू आवर बॉडी एंड देर आर फैगोसाइट्स विच किल्ड दी बैक्टीरिया। ओके दिस इज आवर बिकॉज ऑफ इम्यूनिटी। सो सच एज द दीज आर द पॉलीमॉर्फो न्यूक्लियर सेल्स। ओके न्यूट्रोफिल्स विल डू दैट और द मैक्रोफेजेस। ओके दिस विल डू द फैगोसाइटोसिस। ओके सो सम पैथोजेंस डेवलप अ स्ट्रेटेजी टू इवेड द पैथो फैगोसाइटोसिस बाय सेवरल एंटी फैगोसाइटिक फैक्टर एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वंस आर बीइंग। ओके सो इसके अंदर क्या होता है कि कुछ पैथोजन होते हैं, ये जो फैगोसाइटोसिस जो है मतलब जो खा लेता है बैक्टीरिया को एक किल करता है, उसको भी इन्वेड करने के लिए सम पैथोजन के पास आइडिया है। सो कौन कौन से आइडिया है भाई वो देख लो। एक तो कैप्सूल बना लेते हैं, वो उनके ऊपर कैप्सूल होते हैं। ओके वो ये प्रिवेंट करेंगे फैगोसाइटोसिस ऑफ बैक्टीरिया। कैसे प्रिवेंट करेंगे? बाय प्रिवेंटिंग अ फैगोसाइटिस फ्रॉम एडहेरिंग टू द बैक्टीरिया। ओके इट प्रिवेंट्स द फैगोसाइटिस ऑफ बैक्टीरिया बाय प्रिवेंटिंग द फैगोसाइट्स फ्रॉम एडहेरिंग टू बैक्टीरिया। मतलब अगर ये बैक्टीरिया है, अगर ये बैक्टीरिया है ठीक है, दीज आर द बैक्टीरियाज। अब ये न्यूट्रोफिल है, न्यूट्रोफिल क्या करेगा? फैगोसाइटोसिस करेगा ठीक है। अब जैसा भी न्यूट्रोफिल ठीक है, अब समझ लो आई नो पॉलीमॉर्फो न्यूक्लियर। सो वो इसको जाकर एडहेयर तो करना चाहिए ना किल करने के लिए। सो ये बैक्टीरियाज क्या करते हैं, ऐसा नॉन एडहेरेंस मतलब ये फैगोसाइटिक बैक्टीरिया, फैगोसाइटिक जो एलिमेंट है मतलब ये न्यूट्रोफिल्स है या फिर मैक्रोफेजेस है, उनको उनके सरफेस के ऊपर एडहेर ही नहीं करने देता, प्रिवेंट करता है, उसके वजह से फैगोसाइटिस नहीं हो पाता। सो वो क्यों हो पाता है? क्योंकि उनका कैप्सूल वैसे बना रहता है। सो दे हैव कैप्सूल्स, सो द कैप्सूल्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय कौन कौन से ऐसे ऑर्गेनिज्म हैं जिनके जिनमें कैप्सूल्स होते हैं जो कैप्सूल प्रोड्यूस करते हैं। सो एक नेजेरिया मेनिनजाइटिडेस, सो दिस इज सो दिस कैन हार्म मोर राइट। स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोनी, स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोनी फैगोसाइटोसिस नहीं कर सकते इनका। हेमोफिलस इन्फ्लुएंजी, सो हमारी बॉडी इसका भी फैगोसाइटोसिस नहीं कर सकती। सो क्लेबिसियेलिया निमोनी, क्लेबिसियेलिया नहीं, इसका भी फैगोसाइटोसिस नहीं कर सकती। ओके ये जो बैक्टीरियाज है ये कैप्सूल प्रोड्यूस करते हैं और वो प्रिवेंट करते हैं फैगोसाइटोसिस को। ओके क्रिप्टोकोकस न्यू फॉर्मन्स और फंगस, दिस इज ऑल्सो। ओके नाउ सेकेंड मेथड इज बाय सेल वॉल प्रोटीन। सो दिस में हेल्प इन इन्वेजन सच एज प्रोटीन ए ऑफ स्टेपिलोकॉकस ऑरियस बाइंड्स टू IgG एंड प्रिवेंट्स द एक्टिवेशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लीमेंट। ओके सो कॉम्प्लीमेंट सिस्टम को एक्टिवेट करने से वो रोक देती है। सो कॉम्प्लीमेंट सिस्टम एक्टिवेट नहीं तो इम्यूनिटी एक्टिवेट नहीं तो स्टेपिलोकॉकस ऑरियस ज़्यादा इन्वेड होगा, ज़्यादा इन्वेजन उसका ज़्यादा ये हो जाएगा राइट। प्रोटीन ए ऑफ स्टेफिलोकोकस ऑरियस बाइंड्स टू IgG, सो IgG को बाइंड कर देगा प्रोटीन ए किसका, स्टेफिलोकोकस ऑरियस का। सो वो IgG इंपॉर्टेंट है कॉम्प्लीमेंट एक्टिवेशन के लिए, सो कॉम्प्लीमेंट एक्टिवेशन नहीं होगा ठीक। और एम प्रोटीन ऑफ स्टेप्टोकोकस पायोजिनस, तो स्टेप्टोकोकस पायोजिनस के ऊपर क्या होते हैं एम प्रोटीन। ओके दिस इज वन ऑफ द विरुलेंस फैक्टर ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस पायोजिनस एम प्रोटीन, ये भी वैसे काम करेगा। सेल वॉल बनाएगा, राइट ना। साइटोटॉक्सिन्स, व्हाट इज साइटोटॉक्सिन्स? साइटोटॉक्सिन्स सर्टेन बैक्टीरिया प्रोड्यूसेस द साइटोटॉक्सिन्स ओके दैट इंटरफेयर विद द केमोटैक्सिस और किलिंग ऑफ फैगोसाइट्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल एस ऑरियस प्रोड्यूसेस द हीमोलाइसिन एंड ल्यूकोसिडिन दैट लाइज एंड डैमेजेस द आरबीसी एंड डब्ल्यूबीसी। सर्टेन बैक्टीरिया प्रोड्यूसेस साइटोटॉक्सिन्स दैट इंटरफेयर विद द कीमोटॉक्सिन्स और किलिंग ऑफ फैगोसाइटोस फैगोसाइट्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल एस ऑरियस एंड प्रोड्यूसेस द हीमोलाइसिन एंड ल्यूकोसिडिन्स दैट लाइज एंड डैमेज द आरबीसी एंड डब्ल्यूबीसी। नाउ इंट्रासेल्युलर सर्वाइवल, सम ऑर्गेनिज्म सर्वाइव इन द इंट्रासेल्युलर एनवायरमेंट सो दे आर ग्रुप इन टू ऑब्लिगेट एंड फैकल्टेटिव इंट्रासेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिज्म। ये टेबल में दिखाया है। वंस द एंगल्फ दे डेवलप द स्ट्रेटजीज दैट इनहिबिट द वेरियस स्टेप्स ऑफ फैगोसाइटोसिस। आई थिंक ये हम नेक्स्ट वीडियो में देखेंगे बिकॉज दिस हैज बीन लॉन्ग ओके दिस इज लॉन्ग एंड द वीडियो इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग लॉन्ग। वी ऑल्सो नीड टू सी आवर आंसर फ्रॉम दैट ओके। So now we'll see the answer of question. I hope you all have got correct. Just tell me in comment box that how many of you got correct answer. Okay, what is our question? Question is the true statements regarding musculocutaneous nerve is what receives fibers from 8 cervical spinal root, contains only sensory fibers, it is a branch of lateral cord of brachial plexus and leaves the plexus at point at which it crosses the first ribs. So I hope you all have got correct answer. The correct answer is C, the branch of lateral cord of brachial plexus. Okay, now we'll see some information about musculocutaneous nerve. Okay, so the as answer is C. The what is reference? Reference is Amara BD Chaurasia BDC. Okay. So it is a nerve of anterior compartment of arm. Okay, so one MCQ can be made from this. It is nerve of anterior compartment of. Okay, it is a branch of lateral cord of brachial plexus. This is our option. Okay, so it gives a branch to the shoulder joint and then passes through coracobrachialis. Shoulder joint में branch हो जाती है और वो coracobrachialis से अंदर से ब्रांच हो जाती है और इमर्जेस टू पास इनटू बाइसेप्स एंड ब्रैकियलिस एंड इनर्वेट्स देम। सो बाइसेप और ब्रैकियलिस को इनर्वेट्स भी कहते हैं ओके। देन इन क्यूबॉइडल फोसा इट लाइजेस एट द लैटरल मार्जिन ऑफ बाइसेप टेंडन। क्यूबॉइडल फोसा में क्या करेगा? इट लाइज टू द लैटरल मार्जिन ऑफ बाइसेप टेंडन है उसके लैटरल साइड में ओके। इफ दिस इज अ बाइसेप टेंडन सो लैटरल साइड में वो होगा ठीक है मस्कुलोक्यूटेनस ना होगा। देन कंटिन्यूज एज अ लैटरल क्यूटेनस नर्व ऑफ द फोर आर्म। सो फोर आर्म में भी इसको वही नाम दिया जाता है ओके गाइस लैटरल क्यूटेनस नर्व ऑफ फोर आर्म। सो इट प्रोवाइड्स द सेंसरी इनर्वेशन टू द लैटरल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ फोर आर्म ओके गाइस। सो फॉर टुडे दिस मच ओनली। सो दीज आर द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द एमसीक्यू पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। So I hope you all have enjoyed this video and I hope this video will help you in your study. So believe me guys, we will do lot more videos like this and we will complete total our full MBBS syllabus okay, total UG syllabus we will be completing with this. And we are preparing for NEET PG, USMLE and PLAB. Whatever exam will come, we will crack that surely. Don't worry, just be you can rely on this. Don't worry, okay guys. So क्या करना ही क्या है तुमको? बस यही करना है कि चलते उठते फिरते सोते जो भी करना है तो बस फोन उठाओ, यूट्यूब चालू कर दो, कान में हेडफोन डाल दो और देखते बैठो। जैसे हम गाना सुनते हैं अरिजीत के गाने, जैसे हमको याद हो जाते हैं वैसे हमारा ये भी याद ही हो जाएगा। तो ये मेरा उसके पीछे बेसिक आइडिया है। सो बार बार जब हम देखेंगे तो ये हमको याद भी हो जाएगा ओके गाइस। सो थैंक यू, डू लाइक शेयर सब्सक्राइब If you think this is the easy way to study, oh, this is making your study easy, as it is making mine also. So thank you guys. Let's meet in other video. Do take care of yourself. Thank you. Happy learning.